Today I want to talk about virtual nodes in relationships in APOC, which is a really cool way of using a procedure or function to aggregate information. So to use this, we are gonna use the movie graph. I can just create one with play movies and run this. And in the movie graph, we have actors and directors being in relationship with movies, so we can call DB schema. So we see we have persons related to movies we are directed, acted in, and so on. Okay, with virtual nodes and relationships, we can create nodes and relationships which don't really exist, but are just used for visualization. You can use them with any driver, with the NeoVJ browser, with Bloom, or other visualization tools as well. So it works like this. There are functions and procedures that can create virtual nodes and relationships. APOC create a vnode. You can pass in a list of labels, for instance, foo. And you can pass in properties, for instance, a name bar as node. So this is a function. We have the same as procedure as well. And if you look at this node, it looks like a regular node. It has a label that we can also style and so on. And it has properties. But what's interesting is that this has a negative ID. So all the virtual nodes and relationships have negative IDs. So they are not in the database, and that's why they're also not accessible from Cypher. That's something that you have to watch out for. Virtual relationships can either connect real nodes or virtual nodes or either or. So that's kind of cool. So I can, for instance, find a movie or an actor. Let's see, name. Keanu Reeves, and then we can just create a virtual node, APOC create node, I don't know, location or something like that, and then I don't know where Keanu lives, but for instance, US, as lock. And then we can just return our real node, the location, the virtual node, and the virtual relationship. So we can do apoc create the relationship and pass in the start node. This is our person. The relationship type lives in. And then we can pass in properties. We can say since, I don't know, 2014 or something like that. And our target node lock as well. And so we have a real node, a virtual relationship. That's just as the basics. So, and this worked as well. So you see, we have a real node here, Keanu Reeves. You have a virtual relationship with also a negative ID. And we have a virtual node with a negative ID as well. So what are these useful for now? So first of all, we can use them for aggregation. So imagine we had all actors in our, or all movies in our database. And we want to aggregate them by year into like virtual nodes, like an aggregation of grouping. So we say with movie.year count star. So that's how many movies we have per year. And then we can just return apoc create vnode movies comma, and then year, and count. So we get, 38. Oh, it's not year, sorry, it's released. So we get one node per year, and we can just set the year property, here. And then it didn't work because where exists m.released. I think it's a browser bug. Let's try this again. So now we have our movies nodes that we can make, for instance, green. And we see all the movie nodes, and we see the count on these, for instance, 3 here, 2008 has 2, 2006 has 3, and so on. So that's kind of a virtual aggregation that's kind of useful to collect clusters. So for instance, if you run graph algorithms, you could say I want to group all my nodes by cluster or community ID, and then you get a virtual node for each cluster and community. So actually, yeah, we don't have graph algos installed. I can show this in a later video. So the other thing that's really interesting is to create a virtual graph that only has a single type of entity. So imagine for all these kind of recommendation things, we say, okay, we want to actually create a graph between users based on their joint purchases or joint listens to songs or something like that. And so what we can do with virtual nodes, we can visualize that graph really easily. So I did it also in for Stack Overflow, for Stack Overflow text, but in our little graph here, we can say, we have people, imagine we want to create a virtual graph between people that acted or had a relationship to the same movie, right? So we have two people that acted or directed or whatever in the same movie. And we want to return actually a virtual graph with the two nodes, apoc create v relationship. And the relationship contains for instance, it's a nose relationship, and then we have a count how often they jointly acted in a movie. So, and if we do this, we would create an all the pairs where a joint movie at least one exists will get a relationship. So let's see how many we get. Apoc create v relationship. Oh, sorry, I forgot the start and end node. P1, P2. So this runs and might return a little bit too many relationships. So it's 1300 relationships. So you see that's quite a lot. So what you can do is we can reduce this by saying P1, P2 count where C greater than, let's see, 4. And so they have to have at least 4 movies in common. So it is much less, right? So you have Cameron Crowe is with himself because they, so we should exclude his relationship as well. Let's do this. And where P1 is not equal to P2. So we have our friends from the Matrix that have Matrix and I think Cloud Atlas together. So we can remove the outer connect of nodes here and see that there are relationships between them that should have more than 4. Why does it only have 1? Oh, sorry, because I didn't use C here, but again, count star. So now we should be better. Yeah, so 5, here the count is 5, and we can also, of course, use the count property on the graph visualization here. And so we see automatically how big they are. And if I would use something like NeoVis, I could visualize that into the width of the relationship as well, or any of the other visualization tools. Okay, and so this is super helpful for visualizing these virtual graphs, which we also use often for graph algorithms, so you can get an impression, what does this virtual graph look like, and that's very powerful. And there are some other uses for virtual nodes and relationships that are quite useful. So for instance, if you want to get data that's actually not graph data and you want to turn it into a graph. For instance, imagine you get data from a C3 and you want to turn it into a graph, that's also possible. You just create nodes for the entities and relationships for the values. So for instance, if I wanted to create something like a year property for each node, there's a slight problem that we have to fix. So we have our movies. And then we have the released property. So we see all the movie have their year. And we want to create only one virtual node per movie. But if you want to do a larger match in a graph, it would actually create one virtual node per row. So we have to do some pre-processing. So we just say with apoc create vnode, virtual node. Let's say year, and then we say apoc call group by. So we turn these nodes into a map group by their year property. So it only takes one of these virtual nodes and puts them into a map. Yes, so we basically get back a map of, oops, epoch map. It's not m.released. So we get back a map where the key is a year and the value is one virtual node. So we see here these virtual nodes per year. Yeah? So now when we do our regular match, for instance, we find all the movies and we want to create a virtual relationship to this single year node. We can just return the movie years of movie.released. That is our virtual node. And we create a virtual relationship as well. Epoch create v relationship of movie with in year. No properties and the same virtual node that we just fetched from the map. So that's really cool. So we put it just in like a lookup structure here. So we collect all the years together, the virtual node years into a list, and then we group by the list by year and get one single entry per. It's a little bit wasteful because it creates the nodes first, but it's not too much. So we can, I mean, we could do it with distinct before. That would actually be better. So we could say with distinct emp.released as year. So that would be less wasteful. So we don't create these duplicate entries. And then we do the grouping on this. And this should give us, oh no. What did I do? It expected it to be a text value. Oh, sorry. This map lookup. So mReleased is an integer in Cypher, and in our map we can only have string keys. So we have to do toString on the integer to. So this group by automatically turns stuff into strings for the keys. So, okay, cool. And now we have our year nodes with their associated movies as a virtual graph for visualization. And that's it for today. I would love to hear from you what you are using virtual nodes and relationships for. And if you have suggestions for improvements, what could be better, then I'm also happy to hear that. Thank you.